All right, welcome back. Another 7-arrow drill. Second 900 global ball. Honey badger intensity. Typically, I usually shine with these higher RG balls, but we'll see. All right. First arrow. Oh man, I knew it was gonna strike, but that was way off. I don't even know why I knew that was gonna strike. Like, I just had a familiar thought about, like, that's probably gonna be good there. 7-9. Oh, there we go. Oh, come on, 7-pin. Tried, just didn't get the 7-pin out. Again, I like to see balls that, like, I'm not spot on. Like, that doesn't say 5-0 up there. Seems to be another one that gets a little more forgiving. There we go. Don't hook. There we go. Kind of grabbed it at the bottom, so I was worried she was going to hook a little too much, but got away with one. 3 shots to get off that. Need a couple singles to get back on track. Again, like, it takes a lot of friction to make a lower RG ball faster down lane. It's just going to be slower. Still anticipating these first 3 arrows to be a little easier than the rest. I'll take it. N9. It's like halfway into the 11th board. This is another one of those low double digit asymmetric balls. This is basically just a weight hole type situation. Get the ball to spin up a little earlier. Really got in that one. And yeah. A little too much spin. I just left on that? Huh. All right, 6 shots in. We're only on 3rd arrow. I'll try to go the other way with this. Pull some of the speed out. There we go. So again, the 7-arrow drill is all about, how do I get balls to strike from different places in case I'm put in a position where I see the ball is just not getting there. I can either slow it down, practice that, or hit it harder. On this one, I'll probably have to do both. 4th arrow, 8th shot. It's pretty good. Again, kept the speed down, rev rate up, and worked out. 9th shot, 5th arrow. Again, speed down, rev rate up. Back of the arrow for this. Roll there. Oh, that's pretty good. I want to see the ball see the lane earlier. I don't want to hook anymore. I just want to see it a little earlier. So if I were in practice, I might add a touch of surface. For this, my options are rev rate and speed. I think based on what I just saw, touch left. There we go. 26-4, that's like as close as I can get. So I'm really having to throw this slow to get it to corner, which isn't surprising. 2-5 something RG, I'm not sure. It was in the graphic earlier. Really getting some big flare lines. I'm gonna get a close-up of that. So like longer pin, tighter at the beginning. Then you have that mass bias opening them up, and then you can't really see the dry flares, but they tighten back down as it's in its roll phase. And the thumb hole is the asymmetry usually. The mass bias just moves it away from the thumb a little bit, so it's a little bit earlier. Uh-oh. All right, we're going to focus a little bit. We've got 4 shots at the 6th arrow, and then we'll be giving away an intensity. If you're not familiar with that, that's what this challenge is all about. It's a drill for me, a challenge for me, reward for you, which means if I do it in 14 through 6, then we give one away. Oh, 10 pin away from a free ball. Whoa. Like, I want to see the replay of that pin go around that, because if I don't get this, that's going to be how close it was. Man, where did I just get like 3 in a row? I don't know how I got to here with so many shots left. Oh, that's right. Struck. Oh, 29-2, that's 0.8. Another free bowling ball. Yay. For you, not for us. We have to do a bunch of work, create the entry form so that you guys can enter to win Honey Badger Intensity. All right, seventh arrow, nice and slow, a whole arrow in front of it. Oh, that's really close, hook enough. Oh! 0.4 off from right on it. All right, we'll go to 15, that's two more. So that's like the real point of this, but because this one's so hard, we do 14 for the free ball. So you get one, even if I don't pull this off from two shots. All right, slow. Man, I'm hitting it. That was a half a board off that time. I was 0.4 off before that. I'm gonna keep the hand. This is like the two-hander cheat that most people don't like two-handers for. If you're not good at it, keeping your hand under the ball with your thumb in the ball is like impossible because it just, your thumb can't do that. So the two-handers just put their fingers in and they can go all the way there because their thumb's not in it. For one-handers, you gotta get that in there, kind of get locked up and can't do it. So the key here is keeping that under as long as possible and then just kind of popping it out at the end there. If you ever want to hook the ball more, that's what it's about. Keeping your hand under the ball as much as possible, working from the inside out. Oh, that's got it. Be right. No. Dang, that was right on the arrow. All right. Honey Badger Intensity 900 Global. In the description, click the link, get entered. I have no idea when we're going to give that one away. Yeah, just enter and it'll tell you. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe.